Hey there, everybody. Here we are, chapter 11, talking about YouTube and crushing it collection. So this one's pretty fascinating because obviously he has a lot of context on leveraging the YouTube in order to grow the wine library business that he talks about. But one of the cool things about Gary that he talks about is basically he had done a short-term move, got a little bit of equity in a program, a platform called Viddler, and it totally tanked. And so that was back in 2006. And so he says, what would it have looked like if you spent all that time just focusing on YouTube, which is where things were going to for the long term of where his career is at as well. And so then he breaks it down into a YouTube 101 where he talks about creating of content, understanding that vlogging, documenting is greater than creating, and then goes into YouTube 201, where he talks a little bit about just the context, how to optimize. So a lot of meat in this one. Where I want to take this is, for those of you that are going to stay on for the entire video and you're watching this in YouTube, is he talks about some of the best practices. And so he says, you know, your optimization. So look at your title. Is it catchy enough? Is it optimized? The descriptions, are the top two lines descriptive words optimized? And is there a subscriber link? Are the tags, the questions here, are both one word or phrase tags included? Do the tags actually reflect the video's content? You got thumbnails. Does a thumbnail accurately reflect the video's content? YouTube cards, to the extent watch time on your channel, are you including YouTube cards within the video to drive traffic? Channel optimization, the banner, the channel description, playlists, the channel trailer, and then gives a wonderful example of Dan Markham. Hopefully I said it correctly. What's inside? For those of you that are Gary Vaynerchuk fans, you probably saw him in the Daily V where he goes out to Utah and they end up cutting a WWE belt, which is pretty cool. For those of you that know Gary Vee, he's a huge WWE fan. So obviously they had done their homework. And then in the story, I'm going to do a separate 1 minute clip, but basically Dan and his son decided, it was one of the science projects he had to do, was to cut open a big booger and kind of a big nose, cut it open, see where the boogers come from. And then the following year decided, let's just cut stuff open and then change the name of the YouTube channel. And so he just talks about how they really worked at optimizing it, making it better, and then was actually able to talk to some other influencers, like in the story, Shondoris or Sean McBride was able to tell them about how to leverage it, get sponsorships for your channel, and he had never thought about that before. And so it really became a father and son channel, and then now they have a family one. And so it's really interesting just to see the evolution of working on this social media thing, working on this YouTube channel that really evolved from when it first started. Was just Dan was actually just creating videos for kind of just documenting for family that didn't live in the state, that they could watch what's going on to the family, and then just had put on some Google AdSense. Nothing happened because nobody's really watching, right? It's just family. And then when he had done the one for Booger, all of a sudden made $4 on it. And it was like, oh, what's this? There's some value to this. But then it wasn't until a little bit later that there was an opportunity to have a look at where it was going from the perspective of this idea of cutting different things open. So then change it to what's inside. Dan learned out how to use what's it called? Pro. I'm totally going to butcher it. Final Cut Pro, and how to make a really polished end product was making on a weekly basis. So really cool content there. Sherm's out.